Blackstone Publishing presents The Number of the Beast by Robert A. Heinlein. This book is read by Bernadette Dunne, Emily Durante, Malcolm Hillgartner, Sean Runnette, Richard Powers, and Tom Weiner.
For Walter and Marion Minton.
Part 1. The Mandarin's Butterfly. 1. It is better to marry than to burn. Saul of Tarsus. Zeb. He's a mad scientist, and I'm his beautiful daughter. That's what she said. The oldest cliche in pulp fiction. She wasn't old enough to remember the pulps. The thing to do with a silly remark is to fail to hear it. I went on waltzing while taking another look down her evening formal. Nice view. Not foam rubber. She waltzed well. Today, most girls who even attempt ballroom dancing drape themselves around your neck and expect you to shove them around the floor. She kept her weight on her own feet, danced close without snuggling, and knew what I was going to do a split second before I let it. A perfect partner. As long as she didn't talk. Well, she persisted. My paternal grandfather, an unsavory old reactionary, the femlibbers would have lynched him, used to say, Zebediah, the mistake we made was not in putting shoes on them or teaching them to read. We should never have taught them to talk. I signaled a twirl by pressure. She floated into it and back into my arms right on the beat. I inspected her hands and the outer corners of her eyes. Yes, she really was young. Minimum 18. Hilda Corners never permitted legal infants at her parties. Maximum 25. First approximation, 22. Yet she danced like her grandmother's generation. Well, she repeated more firmly. This time I openly stared. Is that cantilevering natural, or is there an invisible bra, you being in fact the sole support of two dependents? She glanced down, looked up, and grinned. They do stick out, don't they? Your comment is rude, crude, unrefined, and designed to change the subject. What subject? I made a polite inquiry. You parried it with amphigory. Amphigory, my tired feet. I answered precisely. Amphigory, I repeated. The operative symbols were mad, scientist, beautiful, and daughter. The first has several meanings. The others denote opinions. Semantic content, zero. She looked thoughtful rather than angry. Pop isn't rabid, although I did use mad in an ambivalent mode. Scientist and beautiful each contain descriptive opinions, I stipulate. But are you in doubt as to my sex? If so, are you qualified to check my 23rd chromosome pair? With transsexual surgery so common, I assume that anything less would not satisfy you. I prefer a field test.
On the dance floor?
No, the bushes back of the pool. Yes, I'm qualified. Laboratory or field. But it was not your sex that lay in the area of opinion. That is a fact that can be established, although the gross evidence is convincing.
95 centimeters isn't gross, not for my height. 170 barefooted, 180 in these heels. It's just that I'm wasp-waisted for my mass. 48 centimeters versus 59 kilos.
And your teeth are your own and you don't have dandruff. Take it easy, Dee Dee. I didn't mean to shake your aplomb. Or those twin glands that are not gross, but delicious. I have an infantile bias and have known it since I was 6. 6 months, that is. But the symbol, daughter, encompasses two statements, one factual, sex, and the other a matter of opinion, even when stated by a forensic genetohematologist.
Gosh, what big words you know, mister. I mean, doctor.
Mister is correct. On this campus, it is swank to assume that everyone holds a doctorate. Even I have one. PhD. Do you know what that stands for?
Doesn't everybody? I have a PhD, too, piled higher and deeper.
I raised that maximum to 26 and assigned it as second approximation.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.